Hello, everybody. So I'm back real quick. Now, I said I was not doing a real Bible study today, but I am on the cusp, and I am in preparation for my 5-week relationship series that I will be bringing to you all on my Facebook page for my women's ministry, Queendom Pete. And so as I'm driving, trying to get from the park where I just made a video to where I'm going, this message was on my heart. And the question is, do you really know your worth? All right, I'm getting ready to step on some toes. So if you need to put on your boots and lace them up, let's do it. The question is, do you really know your worth? And I'm asking this question because it's a question that I did not ask myself early on in my life. And as I have been in preparation for my 5-week relationship series on wrong relationships, I'm realizing more and more that I didn't know my worth. And a lot of us don't. And so what I want you to do real quick, and I want anybody that's joining to like, share, invite somebody to listen, because all of us need this word, especially as women. And my ministry is targeted, though I may teach to a lot of people, my ministry is targeted for women of all ages, because I have been such a broken young woman, and my passion is for helping other women who are broken or are going through certain things. And so, do you know your worth? And what I want to do right now is, if you are in a relationship, I want to ask you ladies to take a look at your relationship, because your relationship, the relationship that you are in, is a direct reflection of what you think and how you feel about yourself. And I hear somebody in the back saying, you don't have to be mean. I'm not being mean. Listen to what I'm saying. I look at every relationship that I've ever been in, and I see how it ended. I see how I was treated, and I think to myself, I really didn't know my worth, because the relationship that I was in, what I was allowing to happen, what I was enduring, what I was staying through, who I was committed to, was a reflection of how I really felt about myself. I say that because if I had loved myself more, and if I had valued myself more, I wouldn't have been in that situation. So if you're in a relationship right now, that relationship is a reflection of how you really feel about yourself. Because some of us, and I'm single, and I say some of us to say us as women as a whole, some right now are in relationships that you know you should have been gone out of, because if the truth were told, you know that you deserve better than what you are currently accepting. But because you don't know your worth, and your mind, I will never get better than this man that mistreats me. I'll never get any better than this man that is cheating on me. I will never get any better than this man that is abusing me. I will never get any better than this man that I have a child with, but he doesn't treat me right. So in your mind, you will never get any better than what you have. But I'm here to tell you that you serve a God who has the best for you. Not good, not better, not mediocre, the best for you. And right now, if you don't love yourself enough to walk away from that unhealthy relationship or that unhealthy situation, you are blocking God's best for you. And I know that when we have fallen in love with somebody, we think that's the best thing since sliced bread, that we could never possibly get anything better than him, even if he's mistreating us, even if we feel like we have to compromise to be what he wants us to be. We will endure hell and back for the wrong man just to say that we have a piece of man instead of no man at all. And I'm not judging. I'm saying this because I did it. I stayed in relationships with people that cheated on me that I wasn't even married to, but I loved them so much that I valued myself so much less than them that I would stay. And I would say things like, well, they're a good person. They just made a mistake. No, ma'am, they don't value you. Why? That's the bigger question. Not only do you know your value, but why don't you know your value? That is very, very, very difficult to look at sometimes, because we really don't want to admit that we don't know our value, and we definitely don't want to talk about why we don't know our value. Many times we don't know our value because we have never, ever loved ourselves enough to say, I deserve better. And that's why I didn't know my value, because for a lot of years I had some things in my life in my younger years that made me in such a way that I didn't really like myself and I didn't love myself. Therefore, I did not know my value. And so anytime that you find someone who doesn't know their value, somewhere they don't love themselves. Because anytime that you love yourself and you know your value and your worth, you love yourself enough to say, you know what, I might care about you, I might love you, but I deserve better than this. I love me more. You know, you gotta say to yourself, how much do I really love me? don't I love me more than this? And I had to do that in my last relationship. And I thank God that I had been through so many messed up relationships by that point. Because once you've been through something enough, and God begins to work in your life and teach you how to love yourself, it becomes easy to walk away from something that is less than your worth and value. That's right, Miss Cheryl. A little bit of something is better than a whole lot of nothing. That's so wrong. And that is the mentality that we have as women. And we got to come up out of that. I don't care if you got to be single for 10 years. And I say all the time, I tell my mom, I'm like, man, Mom, I'm so glad I'm single, because I would rather be single waiting and preparing for the right man than to be in a messed up relationship because I'm desperate not to be alone. Being alone is not a bad thing. And we got to ask ourselves, do I know my worth? A lot of us are sitting in relationships with people right now that don't deserve our time, don't even deserve to look at us, because we don't love ourselves and we don't know our worth. But the bigger issue, we've asked the question of, do you know your worth? Then we ask the question of, why don't you know your worth? Now I want to ask you the question of, why doesn't the person that you're with know your worth? Because you don't. You cannot walk around expecting for someone to treat you at your worth and value if you don't even know it and you don't even treat yourself like that. How are they going to know to treat you that way? You don't know. You don't treat yourself like you have any morals and values. And so how do you expect this man that you're in a relationship with to treat you like you have morals and values? You don't act like you're worth being more than being cheated on, so you can't expect for that man to treat you like you're worth more than being cheated on. Understand what I'm saying? Every relationship that I was ever in, I didn't love me, and I didn't know me, and I didn't know my worth, so I couldn't demand that worth being given to me by somebody else because I didn't know it. All people can only treat you how you treat yourself, because how you treat yourself sets the standard and the value for how other people are allowed to treat you. If you love yourself and you value yourself, people already know, I can't step to her with that kind of mess. I can't treat her just any kind of old way, because she doesn't treat herself just any kind of old way. But if you're in a relationship with a man and you're staying and you're allowing him to keep on cheating on you, you are reinforcing the idea to him that I don't know my worth, and it is okay for you to continue to do what you're doing to me because I don't even know that I'm worth better than that. And I did that for a lot of years. I wasted so many years with wrong people because I didn't love myself. So I was trying to love them, and I was trying to make them love me how I thought I should be loved. The truth is, I didn't know how I should be loved because I didn't even know my worth and value. And so you have got to know your worth, and you have got to know your value, because if you do not know it, you will continue to get into relationships with other people who don't know your worth and value, and they're not going to treat you as such. Do I know my worth? That is a question that when God forced me to really ask that question, I was like, man, I don't know. And it hurt. It hurts so bad when you realize that you don't actually know your worth. But the awesome part about it is, we serve a God that loves you so good, he will love you into healing. And then what happens when you fall in love with God is you find out what true love is. I have had parents all my life. They've been married all my life, been together all my life, been together since they were like 13 and 15. My parents are now almost 50 years old. I've had the best set of parents in the world that love one another, and they have taught me what love is. However, I personally have not, I didn't have my own standards as to how to love myself. I didn't have self-love. So I was out here in the world trying to get people to love me how I thought I should be loved, when it starts at home. You hear parents and teachers say all the time, how your child acts at school is a reflection of how they act at home. It starts at home. That's right, Brother Rod. It starts at home. So it starts with you. How people treat you, how people love you, how people receive you, how people talk about you is a reflection of yourself. Right now, I'm single and I get hit on all the time. I don't want to be hit on. I want to be courted. And so they know that they cannot do that because I cut it off at the pass. I had a man the other day. I was at the gas station, and I was getting some gas, and he was up at the door, and I was at my pump, and he was hollering out to me, hey, hey, hey. And I looked at him like, I don't know who hey is, but it's not me. Okay, you got to set standards, and you got to set boundaries, and you have to stop being afraid to set standards and value and to love yourself and value yourself because you're scared of being alone. Baby, I would rather be by myself and happy and lonely sometimes then in a relationship, unhappy, devalued, not loved, and disrespected, and with somebody that doesn't know my worth. And it, I have a fire, y'all. I seem so hyped up about it because I have a fire in my belly for young women who walk around in relationships with men that are mistreating them, that are using them, that are abusing them, and they don't know it's nothing wrong with it. And I'm like, baby girl, do you know that your Father in heaven has said you are a queen? Like, do you realize that you are worth so much more than this? But because you don't want to be by yourself, you're staying with somebody that you know doesn't love you, that you know doesn't value you, that you know has absolutely no respect for you, but you don't want to be by yourself, so you stay. Do you know your worth? We gotta ask this. We gotta ask this when we're single. We have to ask this when we are in relationships. We have got to get up every day of our lives and ask ourselves, do I know my worth? Because if you don't know your worth, you're gonna keep going out there repeating cycles, getting in relationships with people that don't value you. As women, we will waste time in a relationship with somebody that has made clear to us that they don't want to marry us, but we hold on to hope. And we will keep on, well, it will ask, you know, he'll ask me one day. We talk about marriage sometime. He said we're going to get married one day. No, 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 no. Sir, what is your intention with me? Because my worth and value says that I am a wife. I'm not a plaything. I'm not a girlfriend. I'm not a baby mama. I'm not a side piece. I'm not a side chick. I'm not some random hookup. I'm not some casual fling. My worth and value, according to my Father and according to myself, says that I am a wife. What is your intention with me? Because if it is not to make me a wife, if you're just looking for somebody to lay up with, can't do it. If you're looking for somebody to occupy your time until the real woman that you're interested in comes around, can't do it. I know my worth and value. I can say that with confidence now because I'm 26 years old. I didn't start knowing my worth and value until last year in August when I walked away from a relationship that I thought that was going to be my husband. And the way that I knew that I loved myself finally and I valued myself was I started saying, you know what? I don't have to deal with this. I don't have to put up with this. I'm worth so much more than this. I'm worth so much more than laying in my bed crying at night because I can't get this person to respect me. I'm worth more than laying in my bed crying at night trying to force myself to forgive somebody for cheating on me and I'm not even married with them. I am worth more than constantly having to tell somebody they don't make enough time for me or put your phone down, we trying to have dinner. I'm worth so much more than that. So I walked away because I realized I'm worth so much more than this. Your worth is a reflection of how much you love yourself. And how much you love yourself is going to determine the kind of relationship you get into, the way that people perceive you, the experiences that you have each and every day. Valuing yourself sometimes can hurt because it's going to cause you to miss out on some things that you otherwise would have taken up on. It's going to cause you to have to pass up on that man that may be very attractive, but you can already tell from the beginning he's not treating you the right way. And you're gonna have to say, nope, I love myself more than that. I'm gonna walk away from it. Valuing yourself is gonna cause you to be alone sometimes. It's gonna cause you to have to make some choices to not engage in some things you wanna engage in. But at the end of the day, valuing yourself, knowing your worth, is ultimately the best thing you could ever do, because though it may cause you to wait, and you may have to wait for a while on the right person, when the right person comes, it's going to be so worth it. So you got to ask yourself right now, do I know my worth? Or am I just staying in this relationship because I don't want to be alone and I really don't know my worth? Figure it out, because the worst thing you could ever do is waste time in a relationship that's wrong because you don't know your own worth.